Hard Knock TV, Face Mob in the building.
But I know that if I stop, I'll be another nigga headed to heaven, hanging with Pop. These motherfuckers look at me like I'm a slanger, making threats to my family, dog. I'm in danger. Who do you call when these agents want you dead? And they hit these penitentiaries and niggas make a pledge. So I dip and duck the feds. All my homies stuck out on indictments, caught up on the phone talking prices. 25 to life's the mandatory minimum. My whole community gets treated like they criminals.
I know I'm not wrong, man. I know it's some fucked up shit. Cause if you got, and don't get me wrong, I ain't discrediting nobody. You know, fucking Justin Timberlake doing 989,000 the first week. Cool. Can Usher do 989,000 the first week?
You know, 2013.
How much?
I said not in 2013.
Okay, Justin Bieber can do a gazillion records the first week, but can Chris Brown do a gazillion records the first week? You see my point now? You know, I heard a rumor, not a rumor, but I heard it from a credible source that the as a producer on this particular network, they were saying that we're gonna make, you know, this all white now. We, you know, this is gonna be for the young white teenagers now.
This being hip hop?
This meaning hip hop. We're gonna make, this particular show or this particular network for the young white kids. Young white kids. And then I'm looking at myself and listening to this and I'm like, where the fuck do I fit in? I was a part of the craft and the molding of this motherfucking shit. So I know I gotta be a part of this. You know what I mean? I know I gotta remain hip hop history. You know what I mean? I gotta remain there. I don't want 25 years to go by and my kids is 25 years old talking about, man, my grandfather was Scarface, but, and they like, who? Oh, my grandfather was Blastmaster KRS-One. My grandfather was DJ Cool Herc. Really? Who's that? Nobody even know who the fuck Herc is and he invented this shit. All right? Like, this shit's serious to me, man. I take this shit bigger than just a rhyme to me. It's a way of life. It's a culture. You know, respect the brand, dude. If you gave a fuck about this culture in any kind of shape, form, or fashion, you would not put the shit out that you put out. You would fucking slam the door on artists that came in there with that shit. I remember back in the days, man, like Kid Flash had it so fucking tough. You know, MC Hammer had it so fucking tough. And now that shit is like cool now. You know what I mean? And that shit was not even bad. All right? I love this song too.
Yeah, it's a good album. It's crazy about this album that before it came out, I mean, I worked at a label. I worked at Sony back in the days. And everything was single driven. It's like, we don't care about making albums.
That's the motherfuckers, man. That shit, they don't give a fuck about making no album.
And it's all about a video, and it's all about a song for the radio. And if you got some filler stuff in there, whatever. But if you can get us two or three songs on an album that we can take to radio, and then we can
who makes this fucking shit, man? Why the motherfucking people control what go on and what our communities hear, man? Like, why are these people in positions like this, man? I don't get that. I don't get it. Now, don't get me wrong, you got some people that get it. I mean, like, I ain't mad at Leor, Rick Rubin, Zach, Katz. I ain't mad at none of them. Because they get hip-hop. But when you get motherfuckers that's in their 25, 26 years, 30, you know, trying to manage hip-hop groups and shit, like, what the fuck, man? You don't even know my music. Right. How the fuck you? You don't even know me. You want to manage me? Stop. You want to play God with a culture? You want to change this shit? You want to wash this out in 20 years? But I ain't going nowhere.
I built my whole life around you. I thought I found it all when I found her. Shopping sprees on whatever coast. How'd you really feel? I may never know. And as I ride through these streets with my hand on my heat, eyes ran from
from the sweet side. Realize some things never change once in love and it's gone. You don't look at it the same, man. Fuck love, cause she don't live here. I'm soaked in blood, but I'm still here.
It's a fucking. It's like a drive-thru now. You know, hip-hop is like a drive-thru. Man, I guarantee you, man, this shit was plotted against a long time, man. They plotted against this shit a long time to destroy this fucking craft. Yeah. Yeah. Fruity Loops.
We have a lot of artists, you know, that are independent in that. Kind of created their own following, their own movie, created their own brand, so to speak. Do you think that could help preserve the culture better? Because they have a little bit more control in terms of what they put out and
yeah, but they create. Do they know how? I mean, if you're going by, if you are doing this independent and you are in control of what you put out, do you put out the same shit that you hear on the radio, or do you put out the same shit? Do you put out what hip hop is? You know what I mean? Like, if you don't know how to make this shit, you can't make it. If you don't know how to create it, you don't know how to do it. You feel me? And motherfuckers who know how to do it not doing it no more because they found a brand new hustle. You know, shit, man. Come on, dog. Dre. Come on, man. The best in the business. But he said, "Fuck this motherfucker too." He is hip hop. In my opinion, Marley Marl is hip hop. In my opinion, you know what I'm saying. And when you got those two people, those two mastermind, groundbreaking record makers, not making music no more, then you ain't really got shit to go by. You ain't got shit to study. You ain't got shit to learn from. You know. And then you got the powers to be for that shit. Come on, man. For somebody to come out and make a trap beat. Besides Shorty Red, whatever his name is, the dude that originated trap music. If you're not him, then why are you biting his shit? Is it not a crime for biting no more? Do a nigga not get severely punished for biting no more? Like, why does every fucking record sound like one long ass song? Why?
Everybody at the labels wants that same. It's not about finding the new person. It's about finding whoever sounds like whatever's on the radio right now.
But then you look at rock and roll, moving right along.
Yeah.
Rock and roll, moving right along. Everybody know how to play drums and guitars and shit. And everybody can sing and shit. But you're looking at fucking everybody else in R&B, you know, hip hop or whatever the fuck you want to call that shit. Don't nobody know how to play nothing no more. You know, ain't nobody in the band no more. What the fuck happened? What the fuck happened to all the black groups? I ain't even talking about the Commodores or like Maze or some shit like that. But what happened to groups like fucking Mint Condition and shit? Like, where that's at? Like, what the fuck happened? Who stole the soul? Who fucking stole the soul, man? It's gone.
That should be the name of your book.
Who stole the soul, man? That shit is gone, man. And people is walking around this bitch, you know, happy-go-fucking-lucky like nothing is happening. You don't see this shit unfolding in front of you? They knocked your ass out. Ain't no more. It's R&B now. Rhythm and blues. It's not. Used to be soul. Used to be soul. Be music for your soul. That shit is over with. No more soul. Who stole the soul?
Hip-hop, heartbreak, straight-laced, deep bass, 808s plus the mixtapes. Got a nigga feeling like an open lecture. Get away, now you're all in the lectures. Being studied by the college's professors. Now I regret the day I met ya, bitch. I'll be the first one to say it. She ain't the one you wanna play with. I fuck hip-hop.
And if I cry too.
There's rumors that you're gonna come out with a collaboration with Beanie Siegel a while ago.
Not gonna happen.
That's not happening.
Not between now and the next 4 years.
And then your solo project, there was rumors of a couple different titles.
I'm coming. Really soon.
You mentioned a little bit you're writing a book. Can you tell us a little bit about that? What the focus is on that? What you want to accomplish?
I just want everybody to know me. And know what the truth is. you know who the truth is. Like you can't deny how you can't deny how much of an influence the Ghetto Boys were. And I was, you know, to music, you know. And I just want to tell my side of the story, though, from the back, from the inside of it. You know what I mean?